The next unit we're going to cover is titled Reactions in Aqueous Solutions. And we're going to look at a lot of reactions and the properties of these reactions when water is a solvent. So since water dissolves many ionic compounds, we can study the properties of ions in solution. And we're going to begin this discussion by defining a couple terms, and then we're going to be able to investigate the chemical properties of each of these solutions. So, a solution is defined as a homogeneous mixture of two or more substances. And a solution in which water is the dissolving solvent is called an aqueous solution. So the solutions we're going to cover are going to be aqueous solutions where water is our solvent. This kind of lends itself to a couple more definitions and terms. We can say that the solvent is the dissolving medium of a solution. And the solute is the substance dissolved in a solvent to form a solution. And typically, the solvent is present in a large quantity, and the solute is a much smaller quantity. So if we have a cup of water and we take a teaspoon of sugar and dump it in there, the water is the solvent that's present in a more large quantity, and the solute would be the sugar that's present in a smaller amount. So this sets up the stage for the next unit, where we're going to cover various properties of these solutions. We're going to take a look at substances called electrolytes. We are going to investigate precipitation reactions. And we're going to look at solubility in general, when a precipitate will form, when a precipitate won't form, and look at something called net ionic equations. We will investigate acid-base reactions. We will look at oxidation reduction reactions. And all of this is going to come together, and we're going to look at concentrations and solution stoichiometry. So this is going to be what's in store for this next unit, and we'll go into detail about all of these particular topics.